Hey friends, you want to give your apps the ability to read text, analyze images, detect faces with technology like OCR? You can do that with Azure Cognitive Services for Vision, but what about video? I'm going to see some amazing demos today leveraging the Florence Foundation model for state-of-the-art computer vision today on Azure Friday. Hey friends, I'm Scott Hanselman and it's Azure Friday. I'm here with Adina and we're going to talk about some amazing things happening in the space of Azure Cognitive Services and computer vision development. How are you?
Hi everyone. Hi Scott. Thank you for having me. Excited to be here.
Yeah, so there's some great stuff that's been happening for many, many years. Azure Cognitive Services has been a powerful service available in Azure for a long time that we can go and implement in our apps. But there's some stuff happening in computer vision that I honestly didn't believe when I first saw it. What have you created?
So as of a couple of weeks ago, we released the latest version of the state-of-the-art computer vision models. And this project has been in the making, you know, with the AI industry moving towards large foundation models. We also invested in training a large foundation model for vision. The code name is Florence. If you search for Project Florence, you can find the research papers. It's a multimodal model. It is transformer based. And by multimodal, I mean it has vision and language capabilities. It's been trained with a large amount of data, billions of text and images. And it enables like new vision tasks, including searching images and videos.
Okay, interesting. And this is a large multimodal model. And that's interesting because in the past, I have trained tiny models on my local machine that are like, is this a hot dog? This is not a hot dog. And these are very basic, small edge models. They run on my computer. But this is running in the cloud as a service that's available to me. And it doesn't just say if it's a hot dog or not. It'll tell me all kinds of things about the video or the image. Is that correct?
That is correct, Ed, because the model has been trained with an extensive amount of data. It has what we call open world recognition. It can recognize millions of objects from the real world. It has knowledge about landscapes, celebrities, movies. You can think about like the wide amount range of things that it can do. You can also customize it. So while the model can recognize like many things from the real world, there are always challenging use cases. So in addition to using the pre-trained model, you can also customize it with your own data.
Okay, interesting. So you can scope it. You can say, here are specific things, almost like I have the base foundational model. And again, that's probably why they call it a foundational model. And then I build on that foundation to enable my applications.
Yeah, so the large foundational model serves as the basis, as the model that can enable vision tasks. And then we call these tasks adaptation models. These models are fine-tuned from the large foundational models. And then the model customization is the specific fine-tuning and transfer learning that you can apply with your own data.
All right, I want to see it. Let's see it. Make it
happen. Okay, let's see it. So what I'm going to show you here in Vision Studio, this is a no-code experience. So Vision Studio is the portal that you can go try all these vision capabilities. And I'm going to walk you through the features that we enabled, new features that we enabled with this large foundational model. So the first one that I want to show is dense captions. So image captions, if you've seen every time in Office or in Outlook or in PowerPoint, you can see an alt text description of an image that has been generated by the image captioning capabilities coming out of Cognitive Services for Vision. But in addition to the full description of the image, we have also created dense captions. So I'm going to take this image as an example. And then you can see here, let me try again. So I'm going to try this one. And you can see here the description of the full image. And then you can see here description of the regions in the image. So you can see like we have up to 10 images, 10 regions inside the image that we provide description. And think about like how can this further enable scenarios of accessibility or SEO or anything where you want like the full description of the things that are presented in the image. The next one that I want to show you is the actual search capabilities for images with natural language. So what I have here are image sets that we provide as samples, and then you can bring your own images. So I'm going to show you here images from the manufacturing domain. So you can see here a bunch of images. And I'm going to search with natural language. So I'm going to use one of the provided sample here. So this is employee wearing a white safety hat. So you can see here from that image set, you can see the similar images that have been detected here, which are relevant to the text query. To show you like another one, I have here woman engineer in a safety vest. So you can see here the returned images. And you can come in with your own query. So the one that I want to show you, I'm going to say person driving a forklift. And then you can see here the results, which are like, you know, pretty close to, you know, people driving forklifts. And then you can play here with the relevance. So we are showing you here the most relevant, but then because this is a similarity calculation, then, the images are ranked in terms of similarity. So I told you that you can try it with your own images. So you can see here my own set of images. These are my personal images. And I told you that the model has open world recognition, meaning that it can find things from the real world without any metadata. So in this example, I'm gonna show you how we can find landscapes. So I'm gonna put here a query. I'm gonna say Bryce Canyon. And then the results are gonna come back. I'm gonna move it to the most relevant. And then the results are coming back with images from my trip to the Bryce Canyon. So again, no GPS information, no metadata. The model having the extensive information about the real world can find images and it know what Bryce Canyon is. Okay, so I showed you images. Let me go to video. And what I have here, we call this video summarization and frame locator, and we like to refer to it as video TLDR, too long didn't read, or rather too long didn't watch. So same as before, as you were able to search for in a set of images, now you can search within the frames of a video. So I'm going to select this video here, which is a video of retail. And the first thing that I want to show you is summarization. So the summarization comes back with the description of what happens inside the video. And then also it calls out the noteworthy events like spilled liquid on the floor, an employee was seen mopping the floor. And now I can actually go and locate the specific frames. So
how can it understand causality? It said in response to the spill. So it noticed the spill. It didn't just notice discrete events. It noticed that they were noteworthy and that one was in a causal relationship with the other.
The noteworthy part is pretty much like looking across the frames and finding like the key frames with the things which are happening. There is no quite causality, you know, it just happens that these are the things that are happening there. But the purpose of summarization is that it gives you like a short natural language description of like what's happening in the video to give you an idea for what do you want to search for. So let me take you to milk on the floor. And then this one comes back with the frames inside the video. And we have like obviously more than one where you can see like the milk spilled on the floor. And then we had there something about a person mopping the floor. So you can come with your own search query here. So I'm going to be creative and I'm going to say person mopping the floor. Maybe it's not that creative, but let's try it. So you can see here like the keyframes that are found inside the video. And then you can see, you know, the person mopping the floor. And then the last one is run frame analysis. So you can select the frame inside the video. I'm going to stay on this one. And then the same way I showed you how dense captions worked on a single image, now dense captions work in the context of the frame of the video.
That's amazing. There's so many different things someone potentially could do with this. I mean, I assume you've watched a movie before where they had a person narrating it, like a human narrating it for the blind. So the blind can watch a movie and they explain it. This could make videos more visible for the vision impaired. It can allow us to then search videos for events. Like, oh, I saw a video, this woman knocked over some milk. I don't remember where it was. There's so many different potential possibilities that one could go and use with this. Absolutely amazing. This descriptive text for video.
That's right. And think of it as, you know, in the real world, there are all these cameras installed in physical places, you know, for safety and security. And then there are petabytes of video footage that are recorded every day, which are stored somewhere. And, you know, to find anything interesting in the video, interesting to the point where it's useful, you know, for somebody, you know, making sense out of that video, it's almost impossible to find it. And you have to watch like hours of videos in order to, you know, resolve a security incident or whatnot. So this is like the kind of feature that once you have your video footage in storage, you can bring it and then you can actually search for content which are relevant for your use case.
Do you think that it would be possible to take 700 episodes of Azure Friday and summarize them and make them searchable? Or is that silly because we mostly share our screens as opposed to being out in the real world?
I would definitely try it. I think like you can try it. And actually, you can try it with your own video. So what we have here are examples that we provided such that, you know, people can play with it. You can actually experiment with this without even being signed in with your Azure account. But if you're signed in, you can try and you can bring your own video. You put your video in blob storage and then we will index it and then you can run your own search query. So definitely something that I encourage you and your viewers to try.
So I can do that in the Vision Studio now, and then maybe could I do write an application with an API in the future?
So the video summarization is something that we have for now as a playground, and we're looking to make the APIs available. The API capabilities that we have are now only for vector extractions from images. So the image search capabilities that I showed you earlier, that's something that you can code against it today. The video capabilities, the playground is available here, and then the API capabilities are coming in the near future.
That is amazing. So we've got image search, we've got open world recognition, we've got video summarization, I can customize models, we've got maybe APIs coming and some SDK support in the future?
That is correct. So most of these features have SDK support, and then some of them are available only as REST APIs. If you click on each feature in Vision Studio, so let me take you like for something like dense captions, every try experience has links to documentation, to the SDK reference, to the REST API. So this is how you can actually, you know, get access to either the GitHub samples or any documentation that can help you code against the APIs.
Absolutely fantastic. I'm looking forward to playing with this. I've got a ton of video and I want to hear what Azure Cognitive Services for Vision can tell me about those videos. Thanks so much for spending time with us today.
Thank you for having me.
All right, I am learning all about the amazing stuff happening in Azure Cognitive Services for Vision today on Azure Friday.
Hey, thanks for watching this episode of Azure Friday. Now I need you to like it, comment on it, tell your friends, retweet it, watch more Azure Friday.